The conversation I had with our guys after the game, I hope it felt like a loss, to where it hurts a little bit. And efforts to help us understand what type of energy we need to come out and play with. And the second thing I told those guys was, what we haven't figured out yet is we're gonna take a lot of teams' best shot. And that's more from a respect standpoint. When other programs are preparing and watching us on tape, not that it's a fear factor, but it's a respect factor of that's a good program and what they're doing. So, you know, for what Eastern Washington came in tonight with tremendous energy, and obviously they shot the ball extremely well tonight. A lot of it was on their part, but also a lot of it was on our part. And now our edge was on the defensive end of the floor. But I told our guys, you know, I just thought at the end of the day we stole this one. It feels like a loss to me. It should feel like a loss to them. And, you know, we got a very tough opponent in Texas Southern that's coming up next. That similar situation. I've been on the road pretty much the whole time. But is a very, very good basketball team, so there's no need to worry about their record or what name is on the front of their shirt. It's a very good program.
Coach, you know, they made 15 threes, and you mentioned the defensive edge. Was it more of the lack of edge, or was it, you know, the fact that they made shots, or maybe a combination of both? What was your take on that?
Well, I thought in the first half it was a lack of edge. Because, you know, you have to give number 32 the respect that he deserves as a basketball player, his ability to go score it. He actually shot it well tonight, too. In the second half, I thought a few of them was, you know, it was just that night, you know, the rim, it was big. So some the step back three against Al, the freshman kid, at the end of the clock. I mean, I thought it was a few of them. I was just like, okay, man, really. You know, at that point, but I did tell our guys I was happy with more of the grit to continue to fight and never give up, because you never know what could happen. We end up getting obviously the steal late and dumping it off to HD and taking it into overtime.
So the last sequence there, I think HD said the plan was to foul, and it just kind of worked out with the steal there.
Well, the plan was to aggressively try to steal the basketball, and if they call foul, let it be, then that's fine, they gotta go shoot. But I thought, I think the kid might even double dribble before stealing the basketball, and I think he obviously came off his knee, Al grabbed it and threw it to H. But I thought in that scenario, it was more about just being aggressive to try to steal the basketball, and if they call foul, let them call foul.
Is that encouraging? I mean, it's, you know, we see teams all through basketball go through that foul, extend the game, and you were able to extend it and force overtime and then get the win. I know you said it feels like loss, but was that encouraging to see the want to and the fight until the end to force overtime and then eventually win?
Yes, I mean that segment or that part was encouraging because we still found a way to win. And I do believe sometimes you have to go through things like this to test your will, test your character as a basketball team. My thing to them was, I just didn't think we had to put ourselves in this situation. But it started more early in the game than it was later on.
You guys really dominated inside offensively. Did you feel you had an advantage inside in this one?
Well, because outside of the big kid, number 15, the 7-footer, they pretty much was playing with five guards. Even the kid 14 is more of a guard. Even the kid 34. They're more guards than they are interior players. So when not HD or Al, we tried to isolate them inside and kind of play off that. And the other thing we really wanted to do was try to take them off the dribble. I just didn't think, you know, JJ and Lou was getting the calls. And I got on them at halftime too about double clutching. You know, you're not gonna get that call. But being more aggressive in attacking the rim, I'd rather a missed dunk than a double clutch. Because at least if you go up there and try to dunk, I knew you're going aggressively. And it may not be a foul, but it's probably gonna look like a foul. You may get it. But if you go in there and you start double clutching, it ain't looking like that.
Big minutes for Jordan tonight. You know, just what kind of a pick me up was that for him and for this team tonight?
Well, it was good in the sense of understanding that he's still there within him. I know he's been dealing with a lot of back issues or whatnot, but when he's in the game, we do play differently now. You know, that was probably an adjustment, you know, after the South Carolina game of how to get him in there, but still not play with the tempo of getting up and down the floor. We still want to get it up, but being more patient. And we still got to learn that too when he's in the game, being more patient, especially Lou and JJ. You know, every time they get it, yes, in most cases you're able to go by your guy or go downhill, but it's not about that. It's about the best shot for the post. And when we're putting those guys in a ball screen situation and having Jordan roll to a duck in, you know, sometimes you got to, you know, get it sided once, twice. You know, when we get it, when we're trying to do it on the first side, you know, we haven't made the defense work.
Usually at home, you know, you guys are kind of on the other side of this with the other team trying to overcome a big league. I know obviously you don't want to get behind like you did tonight, but is there anything that the guys can take away from just kind of, you know, having a home game that doesn't go like usual?
Well, I mean, even our losses this year, that's been the message. Like, guys, that's going to happen, man. You're not going to always come into halftime up. However many points, there's going to be times, whether we play good or play bad, that's going to happen. My thing is, that's why we have two halves, you know, able to regroup, make adjustments if needed, pick a right, and whatever it may be, there's an opportunity to do it. So that was a good message within tonight as well. But again, it would have felt better if our energy was better and we came in down half. You know, the message at halftime would have probably been a little bit more encouraging rather than just disappointed in our energy and effort.
How's Herndon doing? I know he left a couple different times with injury. Now he came back the first time, but looked like he was in a lot of pain the second time. Any update there?
The first one was just tightness in the calf. The second one, our trainer Lance came in and said, they don't know yet, you know. First thing tomorrow morning when he wakes up, how it feels, and then we kind of go from there. I was happy to see him walk through the handshake line. That's had to be somewhat of a positive message, but probably won't know anything until tomorrow.
I don't think Andrew played at all. Was that just the matchup thing, or is he facing anything injury-wise?
No, yeah, nothing wrong with him. Just early on, I actually made the decision to go with Buddha tonight. And then when we went back with that bigger lineup or with Jordan, I think I kept HD out there. So it wasn't nothing. It was more of a coach's decision.